There are over 27,000 comets, asteroids, meteors, and other objects flying around near the Earth right now. Most of them are pretty small, so they don't pose any danger to us. But some of them are larger, and astronomers need to track their orbits so they can keep an eye on them, make sure that they don't pose any danger to the Earth. Even looking only at the bigger ones, there are still over 1,200 known objects like this considered to be near Earth that NASA keeps a list of. Imagine that it was your job to monitor that list of all of them, and it showed a constantly fluctuating probability that each one might hit the Earth. That would be madness, right? There's no way you could pay attention to all of them. If that's something we wouldn't expect some of the most highly trained scientists to be able to make sense of, why would we do that for, say, you know, an everyday data dashboard? Why would you expect it to be reasonable to dump all of your company's metrics onto a dashboard and expect people to notice what actually requires their attention? Data dashboards often have a really large number of metrics to display, and most of the time, the majority of the metrics will be at okay levels. They won't really require the user's detailed attention. So our big challenge is to find ways to draw attention to the metrics that do need the user to notice them. Just indicating if the number is up or down compared to the previous week or month is not really all that helpful, especially if you have a particular KPI that naturally goes up and down a lot. It's not all that useful to know that it was temporarily trending down. It requires a lot of mental effort to look at that alert, contextualize it by looking at the historical data trends, and then dismiss the alert. It's even worse if you have a bunch of metrics that all have some sort of alert icon. If everything is important, nothing is important. So sometimes designers try to flag only the metrics that have gone over some kind of threshold. If a metric goes above or below a set number, it will show an icon or a highlight color to indicate that that metric is in the bad range. The problem is that it's pretty rare that everything will be completely fine, and then suddenly it's a total emergency right when the metric crosses that threshold. For example, it's helpful to know if your car is slowly running low on oil before it gets to an emergency point where you're forced to pull over on the highway. Usually, there'll be some warning signs with most metrics. So instead of a binary threshold where the metric is either good or bad, consider fading in the intensity of the indicator based on how far past the threshold it has gone. If it's just over the line, that might be okay, and we can have a barely noticeable highlight color rather than a bright red alert icon. We can set a range of problem values rather than a single threshold border and use varying levels of color intensity to show how much attention it really requires of our user.